Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Our today's topic is keratinized epithelium. So before starting with the keratinized epithelium, we should first understand that in the keratinized epithelium, the keratinocytes, they are arranged in four cell layers, which are the basal cell, stratum spinosum, granular and cornified. Okay, these are the four cell layers in which the keratinocytes are arranged in the keratinized epithelium. So first of all, let us study what is keratinization, okay, and the process of keratinization. So what happens is, the keratinocytes are arranged in different layers. The keratinocytes which are arranged in different layers, they undergo what? They undergo mitosis, okay? So first of all, the keratinocytes of the different layers, they are undergoing mitosis. Okay, now what is happening is, they remain in the basal layer and then they divide again. ठीक है, अब ये mitosis, first सबसे पहले ये they have undergone mitosis, उसके बाद क्या होगा, ये लो remain in basal layer. ठीक है, उसके बाद फिर से they will undergo mitosis. So they remain in the basal layer and they undergo mitosis again. That is, they divide again. After this, what would happen is, now in the basal layer, after dividing once again, they'll become determined. Okay, what is the meaning of being determined? It means that now they cannot divide further, so they have become determined. Now what would happen, they will migrate and they are pushed towards the surface. Once the complete division of the keratinocytes, see, this is the epithelium, and here in the basal layer, the keratinocytes are dividing and undergoing mitosis. Once they have become determined, that is, now if they cannot undergo any further division, then what is happening is, they are pushed towards the superficial cell layer. Okay, so they migrate and are pushed in superficial cell layer or superficially. Okay, so this is the first process that is taking place, it is the mitosis. Now after this, what is happening is, after this, the differentiation of keratinocytes is taking place. Okay, first is mitosis, then second process which is taking place is differentiation. In differentiation, what is happening, they are showing changes in their morphology, composition, structure and function. ठीक है, अब ये लोग changes दिखाएंगे in morphology, structure, composition and function. ठीक है, तो इनकी morphology shape alter होगा, इनका structure change होगा, इनकी composition change होगी और इनका function change होगा. ठीक है, after this what would happen, after this comes the stage of maturation. Now since they have undergone differentiation, अब अलग अलग तरीके से differentiate हो गए हैं, तो third would be maturation. okay. So what is happening is the cells are migrating or they are ascending from basal layer to the surface in maturation, ठीक है. Next, the maturing cells, they produce what? Growth inhibitors to stop their further cell division. ठीक है, अब ये surface पे चले गए और जो mature cells हैं, mature cells ये क्या करेंगे? They will produce growth inhibitors. Okay, now after producing growth inhibitors क्यों होगा? ताकि रेस्ट्रिक्ट हो सके सेल डिविजन. ओके, सो दे आर प्रोड्यूसिंग ग्रोथ इनहिबिटर्स टू रेस्ट्रिक्ट द सेल डिविजन. नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज अ केराटिनाइज्ड स्क्वामा इज फॉर्म्ड व्हिच इज द एंड रिजल्ट ऑफ द डिफरेंशिएशन. ओके, सो अ केराटिनाइज्ड स्क्वामा is formed. This is the end result of differentiation. So as an end result of differentiation, the keratinized squama is formed. The dead cells are filled with the densely packed proteins within the toughened cell membrane. अब क्या होगा? जो dead cells होंगे उनमें डेंसली पैक्ड प्रोटीन्स वुड बी प्रेजेंट इन सेल मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, तो एक केराटिनाइज्ड स्क्वामा बन गया, सेल्स डिफरेंशिएट हो गए और एक सेल्स डिफरेंशिएट हुए, एक केराटिनाइज्ड स्क्वामा बना. नाउ द डेड सेल्स दे आर पैक्ड इन प्रोटीन्स, ठीक है, पैक्ड विद डेंसली डेंस प्रोटीन्स इन द सेल मेम्ब्रेन. Now, next what is happening is there is occurring desquamation of these cells. Okay? So next there occurs the desquamation of the cells means jo surface ke cells hain they shed off. Okay, so this is what is the desquamation of the cells, that is the surface cells, they are shedding off. Now here comes the role of the turnover rate. Okay, is part se now we have seen the process of keratinization, how the process of keratinization is taking place. So isse we come to know that at last what happens, the cells desquamate means the surface cells, they are shed off. So here comes the question of turnover rate. Or turnover time. So what is turnover time or turnover rate? It is the time taken for a cell to divide and pass through the entire epithelium. ठीक है, वो जो basal layer से divide होके cells जो basal layer से divide होके पूरे epithelium को जाएंगे, that time taken by the cell is known as the turnover rate. So the turnover rate of the keratinized epithelium is less than the non-keratinized epithelium. तो नॉन केराटिनाइज्ड एपिथीलियम का टर्नओवर रेट ज़्यादा होता है एज़ कम्पेयर टू द केराटिनाइज्ड एपिथीलियम. ओके, सो दिस इज इट अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ केराटिनाइजेशन. आई होप आई हैव मेड माई सेल्फ क्लियर. इन द कमिंग वीडियोज आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वेरियस केराटिनोसाइट्स विच आर द बेसल सेल्स, स्पाइनोसम, ग्रैन्युलम एंड कॉर्निफाइड, एंड we'll be discussing in detail how these various cells are formed, what are their functions, and how the process of keratinization is taking place, and how are these cells then shed off. I hope I've made myself clear. Thank you. Keep visiting.